Hello, and today we are with Michelle Laverne, who is the Director of Development at Le Bis Hotel here in Phnom Penh, Cambodia. Michelle, there's a big debate that has been for many years. It's not a new debate, but boutique hotels. A lot of people say a boutique hotel is X, and another few people say it's Y. What for you? You have 27 rooms. So for me, you are a boutique hotel. But what do you see is a boutique hotel?
Well, we use boutique has been used, as you say, for many size and shape and so on. But I would say boutique would be much more like a home. Boutique would be much more for me a place where people are got used to use the name boutique. But for me, boutique is home. It's like they are looking for a place where they feel really comfortable. It is not a standard chain hotel or whatever. It's an individual hotel. Whatever boutique means, yes. For me, it's a home, away from home, for those guests to come with us, not only here, but around the world.
And I presume, I mean, this hotel is very new. I presume that Le Bis Hotel here in Phnom Penh that fits into that category?
Alors, Le Bis, yes, was an experience tried out in Phnom Penh. We knew somehow we were going to hit the town a little bit with a new concept, and going in that, going for that kind of hotel was a bit of a, I would say, of a challenge and a gamble. After 3 months of opening, I would say that the gamble is paying off. The review we get and the occupation, I would say, we get in return from our guests is making us very happy, and proving once more that basically this type of concept can very well work in Cambodia, and we are ready for the next one.
You mentioned the concept and the philosophy. What is the philosophy behind this hotel?
Philosophy would be providing the guest a sense of and a feeling of, I would say, coming home, be happy where they are, feeling safe, away from, although it is Le Bis, coming home into a place which I would say the buzz is off, they find peace and rest, but at the same time they are like in their own room at home. They have all their facilities, be it all the high tech that we have provided in a room. So really the concept and the philosophy is to give them what they want, and we really tried very hard on that.
Who designed, because it is, it's obviously, it's not a cut cutter hotel or whatever the terminology is. It's not a box. Who designed this hotel?
It's designed by an architect from Bangkok, which, sorry, I don't have the name in my mind at the moment.
Right. But has he done other hotels, or is this his first project?
He's done a couple of hotels in Thailand, but this one is really one of the first one into that trendy boutique type of I would say hotel he has done, and we are looking forward to do a second one with him actually.
Right, and who is the hotel targeted at?
Targeted, which would be the young, I would say the young travelers and the young businessman, be it from Europe or be it from all over Asia, and we are targeting really to that, I would say, brackets and the market of 30 to 35 years old type of business guy. And so far it's proved actually working. We are getting all these people from Singapore, Malaysia and Hong Kong staying with us. They accept very well that sort of new hotel.
Right. Well, what can a guest expect when they stay at Le Bis Phnom Penh? What can they expect? What services do you provide?
From what we are gathering and their comment is that they like the way, I mean, they call it, they use term like it is cool, we don't have to behave differently than we normally do. We can come as we are, very casual and without being bothered. It is very friendly and relaxed. There is no etiquette or strict etiquette to follow. And I think this is what people like, no hustle. It's a free check-in. Actually, here, as you've seen at Le Bis, they check in the same room as the library or the bar and the restaurant. It's all together. So it makes it, I would say, a one-room for all, yes.
Right. And what does the room offer to guests? Do you offer complimentary internet? What services does the room provide?
I know in the room, I mean, the rule one is free internet. I mean, we would not even dream of charging. That would be the end of this hotel.
Is that high speed? Sorry, is that high speed?
Hello, we have both in the room. They can take advantage of the Wi-Fi, which is a bit slow, or they can even plug it through the via cable, and then they have a high speed, a higher speed of internet connection. The other things we have in that room is that their own PC can be directly, once they connect through the cable, they are directly connected to the TV screen as well. So they can actually, they don't have to suffer the smallest screen they have on their PC. They can actually be working on the TV screen directly from their own computer, or watching movie or whatever they want to do.
Right. And a lot of hotels seem to find iPods very fashionable, but I don't have an iPod, so I'm always stuck. What do you offer in the rooms in terms of entertainment?
Well, for answer is that you can use the iPod, but you can use any MP3 or USB key to actually plug in and to actually have your music. You can even plug in the room your USB key into the TV, and you can actually have slides, show, and music coming out of the TV directly, without using the iPod, the desktop as such.
Excellent. And all of this is included in the room price. There's no extra charges for this.
No extra charges for that whatsoever.
Right. And you say you've just been open a few months now. How have the few months gone for you? Have they gone to expectations?
I would say that the first couple of months were a bit slow. We were, I would say, a bit worried in a way. And then came November and September have been above our expectation. And January is still above what we expected. So we are very pleased with the outcome after having, shivered a little bit for the first couple of months.
It takes a little bit of time to get going for anything, I
yes,
imagine.
It does. And it was quite fast. People say that we were, Le Bise is not placed in, normally we should have gone where all the other hotels are, on the riverside. And we are actually the first hotel opening on this avenue, totally on the other side of town. Center, yes, but near the banks, and nobody else has dared to come and set up a hotel yet in Kampuchiakrom for the last 15 years now.
Right, and you say, I mean, it took a little while to get going. Now you have got going and things are starting to pick up and what have you, but you're not being slow in terms of expansion. I believe you've already signed two other hotels in Phnom Penh.
We are in the process, yes, of signing two other hotels in Phnom Penh. One will be in the like and taste of Le Bise, a bit bigger. This was done simply by actually some of the investor came and saw how Le Bise was, and they were taken by it. So now they are considering doing one. The second one on the same, by having seen what Le Bise was doing here, we have another chance to do one in Ho Chi Minh City. So we are looking into that right now at the moment.
Regional expansion plans as well?
Yes, that was the idea. I mean, from the owner and the developer, they were more advanced than me. I thought it would take some time to go abroad, but strangely enough, it's happening faster than I expected.
But the two that you're looking at here in Phnom Penh, whereabouts in the city are they?
They're locally same location within half a mile from the Le Bise place.
Right.
Which for Phnom Penh cause us not a problem, but we don't see it as a Le Bise too. So we are still looking for another name for it.
And in terms of this as well, in terms of the expansion, will they follow the same principle? Will it be the same designer that you're using?
It will be definitely in the concept, it will be similar. Of course, we have learned from the first one, and we will have some additional, services added to it. And in the product itself, we know a little bit more what guests are looking for as well now.
Right. Well, when you say you've learned some different things from this hotel, what sort of things would they be?
We learned that, room don't have to be as big as the one we have now. That's not something they're looking for. We know that for sure people are looking as well for a comfort, a very high comfort. So even in terms of bedding, although we have good bedding in this one, we will go even higher for the next one in terms of bedding quality. And one thing we learn is each room need total darkness. I mean, the blackout, it doesn't matter how modern you go, guests still love their blackout curtains.
So in that aspect, I presume you'll be looking at the air conditioning units, because I find a lot of air conditioning units nowadays, they have these massive, great big LED screens on them that don't turn off. I learned this from my own personal experience from buying one recently, and I turned all the lights off, and it was like, not in your hotel, I must admit, at my house, mm-hmm. and it was like I had a lighthouse.
So from the one we had right. the same thing. luckily enough, we read the book, and we found out that we can switch off these lights at will.
Yeah. I see a lot of your electronics are LG. Your stereo is LG, the TV is LG, the air conditioning unit is LG. Do you have a special relationship with LG?
We don't have a special relationship with LG, but I believe we feel that if we do use a system in a room, we tend to keep with the same make, rather than having five or six different type of equipment in one room. We may have the same name. So let's say the second one, the next one could be Panasonic, but it will be all Panasonic. Yeah? So we are not really looking at LG as our brand for technical wizardry and TV. But one make per room is enough. And it doesn't confuse the guests so much, yes, having different type, different. And it's easy to actually interface equipment together if they are from the same make.
Right. With in terms of this expansion, because this is obviously very exciting, you mentioned Ho Chi Minh, which takes it regional. You've got two also looking at two here in Phnom Penh in close proximity to this hotel. What sort of timescale? When are these hotels going to open?
I would say for Ho Chi Minh, we are looking for within the next 15 months. I mean, it would be that fast. We are currently looking as well and studying a project in Kuala Lumpur. So it will be within the next 2 years, definitely.
Are all these new builds?
For Lubies, there is one thing, is we are looking at least at new building and empty. We are not looking at the moment at refurbishing existing building. The module has to be correct, the space has to be as per our specification.
Right, and the two you have in Phnom Penh, would you be looking at opening them this year, the two other hotels?
We're hoping for 2012, we should be all right to open the next one in Phnom Penh.
Excellent, okay. And you mentioned now in terms of the name, because obviously the Biz, it's a very catchy name. Where are you staying? I'm staying in the Biz. It's easy to pronounce for English, French, any nationality. Will you be keeping the brand name throughout all of the hotels?
I think as we are expanding outside, indeed we have to look at Le Biz very seriously. And we believe that we'll keep the name for each major city, and at least one Le Biz per capital city as we will go along. So definitely Le Biz will be a branded name at some stage.
Right. And obviously now you're looking at Ho Chi Minh, you mentioned Kuala Lumpur as well, two here in Phnom Penh. I believe you have another project in Siem Reap as well.
Siem Reap is a little bit different. Once you start to go to places like Siem Reap, Siem Reap is for a day, is a resort. Le Biz is not really the type of name that we will be using. Currently, we are still looking at defining what kind of name we can then have posted or stamped in resort city, because definitely in Cambodia we will have Siem Reap, but Sihanoukville will be coming soon, and I don't see having a Le Biz hotel in Sihanoukville, but certainly something similar geared up for the resort. So we are still working on the product for the resort type of hotel that we want to develop in the same philosophy or strategy as we have with Le Biz, but for resort.
And once all of those are complete, do you know where are you looking to next? Will you be looking at Bangkok, Hong Kong, Singapore? Where will you be looking at the future?
Bangkok would be nice, but I would say within the next 5 years. And I think once we have Ho Chi Minh and Kuala Lumpur going, it will help us and it will bring more into the big, I would say the big capital players of around the region, yes.
Right.
But definitely Asian is our target.
So for, let's say by 2015, what would your target number of hotels be?
It would be nice, as we say, if we could have at least a dozen of hotels plugged around Asia by that time.
How many, sorry?
A dozen.
A dozen, excellent. Very impressive. And this is a Cambodian hotel company?
Alors, at the roots, yes, it is a young couple of Cambodian owners and developers who are into that market. Linked to them and working with them are actually investors or contact that they have from Singapore or from Hong Kong. So basically, it's a regional already investment. It will become a regional investment with people from, I would say, Hong Kong and Singapore, as I said earlier.
Okay, what pricing model are you going to use? Because some hotels, some budget hotels, I think one in Singapore that's a budget hotel that uses a supply demand that changes by the minute. Their rates are sometimes higher than four-star hotels in the same city. What sort of pricing model are you going to use?
I think for Le Bees, wherever they will place this hotel, they will adapt to the price strategy that there is in that city. Indeed, in Cambodia at the moment, we are below the $100 mark for hotel. If we look at Singapore, a place like this would sell very well around $200 with no problem. But Singapore is a very, very special place at the moment indeed.
So you're not a budget hotel?
I don't think we, in the word boutique and Le Bees, there is any mention of budget whatsoever. It will, this type of hotel, whether it's called Le Bees, and it is Le Bees, will adapt to the price that are practiced in that particular city.
Right. And will you be working with travel agents? How will your distribution model work?
I don't know, working with travel agents is always something that we have to consider. It all depends on the size of the hotel. Basically, when we are operating hotels below 30 rooms, travel agents do not, participate that much into the occupation of the hotel. But once you are looking at hotel 50, 60 rooms, indeed, you are, not obliged, but you are gladly happy to work along with travel agents.
And so the new hotels that you have will be larger than this 27-room hotel. You're looking at 50, 60 rooms?
We think that below 30 rooms is still a little small. And I would say the module that we are looking for the next one will always be between 50 to 60 room hotel development.
Right. And in terms of that, will your website, do you feel that you'll be able to offer a best available guarantee in terms of the website? Or do you think it will adapt, as you mentioned earlier?
No, we really are striving to keep the best guarantee price from our website. This is the name of the game. For Le Bees, the concept is very simple. We don't have that many type of room. They're all the same type, so nobody see the difference. You have a room and you are treated the same with the same room. It's easy for us to monitor as well our price that we have on the. Nothing is confusing. It's simple, it's straight, and it doesn't change.
With 12 hotels hopefully coming online within by 2015, do you have any plans or any ideas or thoughts on joining frequent flyer programs with the airlines so that customers can get points, this, that, the other?
Yes, we will, and somehow we are already talking to this player. The product is attracting some of those airline people, and we'll see what we can do. So the opportunities are actually, it's open.
Who are you in talk with at the moment?
I would rather keep that for another interview.
Right. Excellent. Well, Mr. Levain, thank you very much for your time today. Your project here is extremely exciting, and I wish you the best of luck with the future hotels.
Thank you, Stephen. Thanks very much for coming with us and staying with us as well. Thank you.
Okay.